Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be dealing with the editorial on economy. Recently the figures of the first quarter of this year has come out with respect to the growth rate, how the Indian economy is faring, how the Indian economy is growing. Now the figure of the first quarter of 2017 and 2018 stands at 5.5% as per GDP, and as per the gross value added it stands up at 5.6%. Now when it comes to the growth rate of the Indian economy, it is believed that it is actually declining, and it is not only declining, it is actually steadily declining. There has been an increase in the pace of how it is declining. Last year, if we compare the first quarter, that is of the year 2016-2017, the first quarter of this year, the growth rate of the economy was touching 7% or more than the 7.5%. So the growth rate of the economy has actually declined 2%. So this is actually a cause of worry, and this editorial discusses about this aspect, how a nation like India, which holds a lot of potential, is actually declining in terms of growth rate and what needs to be actually done. So in order to address this entire issue, the decline in the growth rate, we need to actually understand the growth process of the economy. Now when it comes to the growth of any nation, it is actually dependent upon one thing. Number one is the investment you are doing. Investment you are doing in the economy. And second aspect is the aspect of productivity. How productive is your investment? Of late, Indian economy has witnessed the decline in the investment rate in the economy. Now when it comes to investment, investment broadly is done by some factors. Some aspects. And the first aspect of the investment is that of foreign direct investment. Now when it comes to last one year of the Indian economy, we have seen a lot of investment being done in the Indian economy to the tune of 60 billion. So, bahut zyada investment hua hai India mein, to the tune of 60 billion. But still, it has not been able to give a push to the economy's growth rate. Despite 60 billion investment, the growth rate has not taken a jump. So, this is one thing. Now, the second aspect of the investment is that the investment to be done by the government, that is the public sector. Now the public sector to the total investment that has been done in the economy, it stands at about 7.5% and it is actually improving. So this is something that is good for the country. But despite this factor of 7.5% investment being done by the government, still we have only the slow growth rate. So itna growth rate kyun kam reh gaya jab itne positive signs aa rahe hain economy mein. Abhi negative is with respect to the domestic component and specifically with respect to the private sector. Private sector investment hai, and then you have the domestic investment. Investment done by the people. And the private sector means the corporate sector. Now the corporate sector is actually shy of doing the investment in the Indian economy. Now there are reasons for it. We will be discussing it in the latter part of the lecture. So this is one reason that the investment that is usually done by the private sector, it is actually on declining. The private sector is not investing in new projects. Now this is also very important. Now when it comes to investment, investment is either done in the new projects or it is done in the old projects. But with respect to the Indian economy, the investment is not being done in the new projects. Be it the case of the foreign direct investment, or be it the case of the public sector, or be it the case of the private investment. And the domestic investment has also gone down. So these are the two reasons why we have not been able to give a push to the growth rate of the Indian economy. So this is because of the lower investment being done by the private sector and the domestic component. And now there is a need to decipher why the private sector is not investing in the Indian economy. Now, the first important reason for not investing in the Indian economy lies in how the banks in India are performing. Now, the health, the economic health of the Indian banks is actually dwindling, it is actually withering, it is actually declining. So there is a lot of NPA, non-performing assets increase when it comes to the banks. So the banks, they have a high ratio of NPA. We are actually touching very high levels of NPAs. And because of that, banks don't have the money to fund the investment that the private sector really wants to do. Now the second is also with respect to the demonetization. This is another aspect, the demonetization. It has actually had an impact of dissuading the investment. So demonetization se bahut log dar gaye hain ki kis tarah se productivity pe asar hoga. Chahe ek honest aadmi bhi hai, agar honest aadmi bhi agar trade kar raha hai, but wo trade kuch is tarah ke logon se bhi kar raha hai jo dishonest hai. To usko pata hai ki jiske sath wo trade kar raha hai, he is selling the products to the people who are having money, who have earned money, maybe by wrong means. So when such activities like demonetization, they come into being in an Indian economy, so it actually creates a kind of a pressure. Moreover, due to demonetization, Indian economy has lost about 2 months. 2 months of slackening in the growth rate. And the third is with respect to the goods and the service tax. Now with respect to the goods and the service tax, the private players, they have not stocked the products that they used to sell because they were in the fear that what might be the outcome of the goods and the service tax. So unhone bahut zyada stocking nahi karke rakha products ka. Stocking karke nahi rakha to productivity kam ho gaya kyunki demand kam ho gaya to stock karke nahi rakha. So these are the core issues that we are presently facing because of the NPA, the growth rate, because of the demonetization, because of the GST. It's not like that the government has not done anything. The government has brought in numerous good reforms. Now the GST in itself is a reform. Then apart from GST, there is another big reform that the government has brought about. That reform primarily relates to the Bankruptcy Act. This is another good reform that has been brought about by the government. Now how to give push to the Indian economy? We can give push to the Indian economy if we will be addressing this private sector issue. And secondly, we also need to focus on the productivity. Though Indian economy is increasing in terms of productivity, incremental capital output ratio is actually declining. We're actually doing good with respect to the productivity. But the productivity levels should also rise. And there is more importance of investing in new projects. So it is important that the investment that we are getting from the foreign countries, it should be invested in the green field projects, not the brown field FDI. Because if it will be by the way of brown field, we will not be able to generate employment. That is another issue that has been discussed by this editorial. Growth ek aisa hona chahiye jo employment bhi generate kare, thoda inclusivity bhi kar raha hai. Growth ho raha hai, inclusivity nahi ho raha hai, inequality bad raha hai. That is also not good for a nation like India. So this was all for the editorial class. You can subscribe to this channel. Now underneath this video class, you might be seeing a button here of that of subscribe. Just click on this button. So you can subscribe to this channel so that you can get the updates about whenever I will be uploading any class or any decode class on the Hindu Editorial Decode. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.